My name's Caden Robbins. I'm a senior at CSU at the moment studying agricultural business through the School of Agricultural Science. Currently, I am doing an internship where we focus primarily on the producer experience with virtual fencing, which is a technology that is supposed to replace or improve the traditional hard fences. So here we have the tower used for virtual fencing. This piece of technology is probably the most important other than the collars put on the cows. It receives a signal from a cell phone tower, and when we transmit data from the computer to build a virtual fence that would keep the cattle within the range, or even just to check the location of the cows, this tower is what does all that. It'll transmit the signal to the cattle and it gives us the data on where they are. So a major part of this true cost of virtual fencing internship is the collars and the other technology involved in it, like the tower. Here behind us, we have a bunch of cows that have been collared. I've heard of about 33 that were collared. In the collar itself, it detects their movement. It keeps data of where they've grazed, which is a big portion of the technology because it allows producers to analyze how the cattle have been moving on the range and maybe the condition of the range itself based on that grazing. When looking at analyzing the costs of virtual fencing and traditional hard fences, we're looking at whether or not it reduces costs, if it reduces revenue, if it increases costs, or if it increases revenue. So at the moment, when I talk to the ranchers, we look at whether or not the technology is going to increase costs, which is the main one. And at the moment, it does seem to be the case because you're not able to completely eliminate the traditional hard fences, especially the exterior fences, which are the fences that keep the cattle within the range outside of the property that can't be used. And then there's the interior sectioning fences that separate the property into the different portions of pasture. During this internship, I've had the privilege to meet with countless producers. At the moment, I'm at around 10 producers. So being able to do this is giving me the ability to make relationships and learn more about other producers and their operations in different parts of Colorado, which is really interesting. The virtual fencing internship has given me the ability to go outside and experience the range and also apply my degree to something useful for the agricultural industry, which is really unique. So if you have an opportunity to take part in an extension internship, I think it's something that will really help your career. It'll help understand what your degree is used for, and it gives you many great experiences that you can take into your future.